My name is Mitch. I sing in Suicide Silence. And, off the question record, this is Parker. It's my puppy. Mom.
You're older than that.
There you go. I just started working at a shop really young, and everyone had lots of tattoos, and it 100% influenced me to want to get covered in tattoos, because everyone I knew was covered, and they were way older than me, and here I am now. First tattoo I have is either the thing on my lip, it says true, or it's like an old straight edge tattoo that's on my shin. I was like 15 or 16 when I got both, so. Painful, my ribs, everything that I'm working on right now, and my armpits, and my hips, and belly, all that shit's beyond everything I thought was bad, like my neck and my chest, just got completely destroyed once I started getting my stomach worked on. Not much. My really good friend John Montgomery tattoos most of them, and I hook him up with tips as opposed to bang them. Just, it's the friend workout, you know? Both really good friends, and he's always helped me out with just putting amazing artwork on my body without necessarily having to pay for tons of it, you know? It's like $1 million artwork, but it's the friend that counts. The one on my hand for my daughter. It's this big flower. It has my daughter's name right there, Kennedy. And I got it like 2 days after she was born, so just definitely, it was a huge thing. It's like, oh, my daughter's born. It's like one of those things, a huge chapter in your life, and I wanted to have it put on me and just remember it for the rest of my life. And so this whole flower in my hand was just one thing for her. It's called, Grand Tattoo Lodge in Redlands, California. And it's John Montgomery's done every tattoo on my whole body, and it's his shop, and he is by far the best tattoo artist that's worked on there. Amazing artwork by far. Style? I like traditional Japanese and old traditional American, but with like new colors. You know what I'm saying? Like really traditional Japanese and really traditional American, but try to find like the line between the two of them. Next, I think me and John, once he finishes my torso, we're gonna put a huge goat head on the back of my neck. It'll be right side up when I'm standing this way, but then when I go straight, this way will still be right side up. So it'll be like, no matter which way you look at it, upside down or right side up, it'll be centered. Society's views on tattoos, I think it's becoming more and more tolerated, more and more mainstream. Not so much like a gypsy thing, not so much of like he has tattoos, shun him. It's so much more tolerated now, especially in the States and overseas. It's just someone with tattoos, it's not so much a bad thing anymore. Do it. Do it, make sure the artist is good so you don't have a shitty tattoo for the rest of your life. Some people are really ignorant or shallow when it comes to like views on people, but other than that, it's tolerated everywhere. It's just normal. Like people ask you tons of questions about it, but it's just questions. It's not like they're insulting you or anything. I don't know, Parker. What a girl think a tattoo is, buddy? Yeah. Most girls that are interested in tattoos are into guys for the wrong reasons. For the same reasons they want to come hang out because you're in a band or something like that. It's just the shallowness. Some girls are shallow, but some girls actually like their artwork, so it's whatever. No, I'm happy as fuck with what I have. And some of the stuff I'll never cover, some I will, but it's like, It's who I am. It's made me who I am today. And it's all like, I remember each tattoo as if it's like history. It's like, I remember the day I got that. I remember the day that was getting colored. It's kind of cool in that sense, in that way, you know? If you just get tattooed and you're around, like, and you're playing shows, and say you're in the bus and then venue at festivals, I've seen so many people get tattooed on festivals like Warped Tour or Mayhem and just have them get so infected and gross. It's like, whoa. I try to stay away from getting tattooed when I'm on tour, but I still end up getting tattooed all the time when I'm on tour. Like, this Buffalo Wild Wings tattoo I have, definitely a tour tattoo that I hope stays with me forever, because it's a delicious, delicious place. I try not to get tattooed by anyone but John Montgomery, but there's always those times where like, hey, want to get tattooed? Sure. And just get like my knuckles done, or like these diamonds, any random thing, no. It's huge. There's a ton of dudes here today that have like lyrics on them, or like big metal, the metal logo, or anything. It's like, that's the ultimate fan commitment, you know? That's like real shit. I back it 100%. I think it's sick as fuck. Okay, yeah. This flower represents my daughter, and only demons protect children from pedophiles. And these two dudes hanging from the shit are pedophiles. That's just what it represents. And this is just super peaceful. Buddhist leaf, water, and flowers. Dude, look at how hot it is. I'm sweating. Look at that. It's like glistening. And then shit on my neck. Oh, dude, I'm really sweating. It's hot. Look at that. Thanks for the interview on EconHonor.com. Listen to Suicide Silence. Love, Boston Terry, puppies.
It creeps me out that Alex can do that.